Hello, my name is Yegor Morozov. I'm currently working in the Institute of Biophysics, Siberian branch of Russian Academy of Sciences, on increasing closure of life support systems for long-term space missions. And I'm a PhD student in Siberian State Aerospace University on the same topic. The Institute began in 1960s when chief designer Korolev funded a project to establish long-term research base on Mars because for a mission more than 2 years, it is cheaper to organize material cycling inside the system than to take storage. And laboratory is improving life support systems for long-term space flight still present. Here is biosphere facility where people lived up to half a year regenerating oxygen, water and food, and lunar experiments are being planned now. Simple, effective, ecologically clean method of organic waste treatment to include them into system to nowhere called wet incineration has been developed at IBP. A big problem about this method is hardly dissolvable sediment, where such essential nutritive elements as calcium, magnesium, phosphorus and iron fell out of system to nowhere. My current work is making these nutritive elements available for plants grown on hydroponics. Burning of sediment in nitrogen acid and hydrogen peroxide allowed to make more than 90% of each element available in nutritive solution. This allowed us to increase crop yields more than twice on example of salad, where some elements in the sediment were limited. And the improvement of technology I have done is likely to be used in full-scale experiments by previous people. Hydrogen peroxide for wet incineration is recovered inside the system by electrolysis of obtained solutions, making the method accessible and affordable. Closed life support systems have lots of applications, including commercial, but major need for it I see as essential part of spacecraft carrying crew and equipment capable of full-scale terraforming and inhabitation of new planetary systems. This allows a population quantity and quality grow infinitely. This allows a power to grow infinitely. The farther we are spread, the more our chances for long-term survival, the more our ability to configure all matter of infinity and eternity. Such endeavors require large diversity of genetic pool, which means heavenly development of space infrastructure all around the globe and large facilities all around the equator. I see rates of cosmic expansion of life as supreme aim, value and criteria for any behavior. It's not just pure curiosity, it's basis of our long-term survival and scale of influence.